all the fakes. Phone never own. I don't camera stand. I don't compromise. I just pin a trick. Money, these are the breaks. These are the times. Level number 9. Look up in the sky. Tennis on the way. Sinners on the way. On the way. I got winners on the way. You ain't without a on your belt. You ain't without a ticket on your plate. You ain't sick enough to put it on yourself. You ain't rich enough to hit the light escape. Tell me when this stretch ain't gonna be my fate. Gonna be a fake. Gonna be a fake. Peace to the world. Let it rotate. Money, I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. Quarter piece, got war and peace inside my DNA. I got power, poison, pain, and joy inside my DNA. I got hustle, though ambition flow inside my DNA. I was born like this, is born like this, immaculate conception. I transform like this, perform like this with new weapon. I don't contemplate, I meditate, then off your head. This that put the kids to bed. This that I got realness. I just killed this.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports. A pair of tight ends will be on the field today looking to do whatever it takes to give their team an advantage. It's the Cowboys going up against the Panthers. With that, it's time to hook up with our commentators in the booth as we turn it over to Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a moment ago, the lights, the cameras, the action, all the pyrotechnics, everything was ablaze, everything was allowed here in Bank of America Stadium as Carolina emerged from their tunnel. And we are ready to go as the Panthers get set to match up with the Dallas Cowboys. Hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we saw Larry focus on the tight end matchup in his open. You think it's one to watch, don't you?
Definitely one to watch because these guys can create such big plays by all the different things they can do. Line up out wide, in the slot, line up at a normal tight end position, and then who are you going to cover them with? Is it a linebacker, a defensive back? They create mismatches all throughout the game.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. On first and 10, Newton out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And oh, right away, he lost the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys.
As you and I both know, one reason teams script plays to start a game is so they can practice them ahead of time. I will guarantee you, that fumble was not in the script.
You don't think they had fumble written next to play one there?
No, that was never in the script because they want to have good memories when they go into a ball game, not something that could have gone wrong.
Well, we got a second here before this next drive starts. It seems like every week we're talking injuries, and we had 3 quarterback shoulder injuries from this last week.
Yeah, and it's really unfortunate because we're talking about some of the most recognizable players in the league. Jameis Winston really coming on as a young quarterback. Trevor Siemian, captain of the Denver Broncos.
And that is caught. It's Witten for the Cowboy touchdown. Jason Witten, 26 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. Well, what a quick turnaround there. They get the football. Next play, boom, touchdown.
I've been in a situation before where a turnover occurs, and if you're over on the bench with your defensive mate and you talk about what to do on your next series, and all of a sudden you hear sudden change, you've got to get out on the field and defend right away. Not everyone is mentally prepared to go.
Is that what is yelled on the sidelines a lot of times?
That, among other things.
Maybe some words we can't share here.
Yeah, we'll just keep this with PG.
FCC violation.
No doubt.
Well, before this next offensive drive gets going, you know, we still have two 0-6 teams in the NFL, the 49ers and the Browns, and you're looking at me because I know you made a prediction that one of these two teams would win this past week.
Yeah, we had the Giants in there going into it as well, right? We had the Giants, 49ers, and Browns.
And his first carry, he loses the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys, and they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
Okay, after those first two drives, I think there's a head coach who's going to be calling for CSI. They're going to want some forensics on this. What is going on with this ball club? unable to hold on to the football and take care of it.
Yeah, two straight fumbles for them to start out.
Yeah, you would think that this team would come in ready to go. Sometimes just mentally not prepared, and it shows up in these types of plays. Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and 11.
Yeah, and that was a safety that came through and made the play. But there's no doubt in my mind, he hits like a linebacker. We see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed. A big hit for a loss. And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down. Charles, that's an important third down stop. You don't want to spot him two touchdowns here early.
You're trying to slow momentum down. You've already given up the score. They're coming right back at you. You're exactly right. Being able to hold them there and force a decision on fourth down, that's big for the defense.
20 yards on the pickup there. And the Cowboys are going to get a first down. The numbers for Dak as a rookie last year are still kind of mind-boggling. And you look at QB rating. Dak was 104.9. Now, among full-time quarterbacks, only two Super Bowl quarterbacks, Matt Ryan and Tom Brady, were higher.
And look who he finished ahead of. Guys like Aaron Rodgers, Drew Brees, Russell Wilson. Amazing.
15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
All right, I'm doing my rudimentary math here. That's his third catch here in the first quarter. I don't know if it's just game plan.
And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
Yeah, that was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. That time, a 6-play drive, and it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Bailey now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Following the penalty, here's Stewart. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. It's a gain of 3, and it'll be second down. Second down following the run. A shotgun snap for Newton. And it's hauled in by Ed Dixon. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game. You absolutely have to have this early on, right? Third and short, they elect to throw for it, and that's normal NFL football. They're going to throw on third and short, but you've got to hit it, don't you?
Yeah, in the first quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect there. Pilardi now. on to punt as he sends this one away. This is taken at about the 14. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They go play action here on first down. Going up top. Tough. And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Cowboys. Dez Bryant, 81 yards. And the Cowboys will extend their lead.
Well, Brandon, if we go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator, he showed us his script. Didn't show us everything now. He said, here's the script for the game. I think everything's going according to plan in a big way. Three drives, three touchdowns.
Yeah, that's about as good as, that is as good as you can do, I guess. So, well done.
Yeah, well done indeed. Tremendous execution.
Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives from that distance. What an effort. It results in the touchdown. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive, you're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
On second down, here's Newton. It's caught right side, Dixon. And he's going to be out of bounds right at the 40. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
I like how they work the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
And able to get a couple as he's across the 40 to the 41.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Second down, they run with Stewart, and he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right now. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action, hit them over the top.
It's caught, Shepard. Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Russell Shepard, 57 yards. And the Panthers, they're able to draw a bit closer. It's up, it's good, and that'll cut the lead to 21-7. Back here with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. We've had Gano out to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. Particularly good return here as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
And a nice gain of 21 yards.
They had two tight ends in the formation on that one. It looked to me like he had his pick of receivers downfield.
I think he was just planning on going over the middle. That's what he did.
Picked up first down, too.
Buying time to his left. And he is knocked down from the side at the 36. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
On second down, Elliott. And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Now Prescott. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Charles Johnson able to drop him for a loss of four. So shall we say a bold decision to go for it, and that bold decision does not pay off.
And when you talk about bold, you're saying all caps?
All caps.
Yeah, with that.
Looking for Funchess, but it's intercepted. Picked off at the 21, and he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's airing it out for Williams. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. It's the safety, Kirk Coleman, and this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
They'll start the drive with a run by Stewart. Finding some room at midfield. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
By the way, partner, that was a 30-year-old running back carrying the ball there.
Yeah, turned 30 back in March, did Stewart.
Yeah, I know that people say that you're not supposed to at the age of 30, but Jonathan Stewart, good style, good physicality. He'll continue to run it.
Hoping to keep him healthy. Hasn't played a full 16 games since 2011. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Boy, that's a lot of sirloin steak to be taken down for no gain, partner.
Are you trying to suggest that he is a huge man?
And oh, my goodness, he loses it again. But fortunately, a Panther was able to get on this, so Carolina keeps the ball. Two minutes remain here in the first half. Back with more from Charlotte. Third and long, it's Newton. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey. 20! Touchdown, Carolina! A big play there! 47 yards! And the Panthers have got it back to a one-score game. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go.
He's got a man complete. And all the way down to the 42. A big play here for Dallas. 43 yards.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
He's going to go deep for Beasley. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
The way he's been slinging in the first half, you expect everything he throws to go for a touchdown, but I guess he's got to wait to try and pick up that third, isn't he?
Yeah, I thought he had him for a second, but you're right, not to be. Throwing again, Prescott on second and 10. Throw right side, complete to Williams. Give him 12 yards on that one, it earns him a fresh set of downs. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after play. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
On second down, Prescott again. Now he'll go deep. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. 30 yards, and the Cowboys will add on to their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Bailey now for the extra point. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. So that drive spanned five plays, and it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. Bailey now to kick this one away. Fozzie Whitaker now on the return. And onto the field, here come the Panthers. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Now Newton on first down. Funches with a catch over the middle. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Here's Newton now on second down. He hits Stewart in the flat. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Now a first down throw for Newton. A jump off here to Stewart. And Stewart lost the football. It's loose. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey,